Hello, this is Mike Zmuda with techytube.com, and today we're going to go over some UI controls as well as some Visual Studio tools that we can use to make Windows Store applications. So basically, when we're talking about layout, there are two main kinds, fluid and static layouts. So basically, a fluid layout will shrink and grow and change depending on the visual space on a device. Previously, this was kind of thought of as changing based on the window resizing or the user's resolution. So that lets you kind of ensure that your app will look properly or will look as you intended when you designed it on different devices. Now, as opposed to a static layout, that is where you explicitly set positions and spaces between controls. Those don't resize, so if the device is a resolution other than the one you designed it for, it'll generally be stretched or clipped or changed in a way you probably didn't intend. So generally, fluid layouts are best, and especially with Windows Store applications, because they are runnable on a multitude of devices. So that's basically layout two types. Now we're going to look at different containers we can use. So those of you who have used WPF will probably be familiar with some of these and the grid in the panel. Those of you that haven't, there's a root grid in each application. And that's basically something that lets you lay out your app like a spreadsheet, so you have cells and rows and columns and all that. A stack panel it basically lets you arrange content in a single line, so items stack on top of each other. You can use the orientation property as well in case you want it to go horizontally or vertically, so you're not constrained to any particular orientation there. And now Canvas is basically a static design container because you explicitly set the positioning using the Canvas top and Canvas left properties. And as well with any child elements, they won't resize either, so you will have to size them as well. So even if you put a stack panel in a canvas, you would still have to size that stack panel and position that stack panel properly. Now, when we're looking at controlling the size and position, so basically where a control will actually appear on the screen, there are a couple properties we can use to help with that. So horizontal alignment and vertical alignment, in relation to its parent object, you specify where it'll go. So for example, if you have some kind of panel container and you set horizontal left, it'll go to the left instead of the right. If it's laid out vertically though, if you specify the top, then your item will go to the top first. So basically like a text alignment just with controls. A margin you can think of as kind of a buffer or border around your control. So if you need a certain layout to always be 5 pixels away from the edge of your control, then you just set that as the margin. Width and height is when you want to specify fixed values for your control. And min width, max width, and min height, max height specify basically what your control can never be bigger than and what your control can never be smaller than. So that way, fluid resizing works because there's a range in between that the control can automatically adapt to. So we're going to use these to create our photo page. So before we do that, we're going to quickly go over the tools. If you've used Visual Studio, these are probably really familiar, but if not, just a quick refresher. Compared to some other IDs you may have used. So Solution Explorer leverages the concept of a solution. In Visual Studio, a solution can handle multiple projects and other items. So a solution will be your root work element. If you've used Eclipse, a solution is kind of like a workspace. Not really, but it's the same kind of idea, the current area that you're working in and where you import all your projects to. So we've touched properties a little bit. Basically, properties allows you to change the name value pairs, which is what all these items are when you get down to it. Some of them have multiple values though, so for the margin, for example, you have the left, the right, the up, the down. But basically, these are arranged by categories, and they have individual elements such as width and height and such. So that's what you will use if you are changing anything about an element. You're doing it through the designer and not in code. And just one thing we'll mention, which I don't think is on the rest of this tutorial, is the events button there, and that lets you set up event handlers. So as in previous versions of Visual Studio, click on that, quickly find the event you're looking for and do a double click, and it'll automatically create that event handler and do a quick skeleton code insert, and then you can put your logic in there. So we've done quite a bit of work with the XAML designer. It's basically like the blend canvas, more or less, in that you drop elements, you can select them. When you do select them, your properties will become filled up and your events will contain all the events that apply to that control. We've used the editor. It's basically just a text editor that is that has some XAML features in it, such as syntax highlighting, etc. So it helps a little bit that way. The toolbox on the left, again, probably familiar, is where all of our controls go. You can use different categories, you can import new controls, but basically if you're going to use controls, you will drag and drop them from here onto your designer. Now, couple new things. We have the device. So basically when we're talking about targeting your applications for different devices, we can change things like visual state. So if you want to set it to landscape orientation, your display resolution, basically display types. So you'll select a bunch of different device display types there in a drop down. Theming it, showing the Chrome, which is basically some of the UI features that make it look a little bit nicer. Override scaling, so basically don't scale. And clip to display, so basically clip off the edges. Document outline is helpful if you like XML, or if you're familiar with some of the XML tools out there. It basically lets you explore the XAML markup and going to specific items. You can do it in the XAML text editor as well, but sometimes you have to kind of hunt for the part you want, and this kind of gives you a nice hierarchy of how your document is laid out. And these may appear in different places depending on your layout, whether you use C# layout or JavaScript layout or etc. And those layouts are kind of tailored to give you a default workspace, but you can move these windows around, which is really nice, and dock them in different places. So that's what we've gone over today, is basically the Visual Studio environment and some of the common basic controls that you're going to use. So next, if we page down here a little bit, we're going to go further into actually performing operations in Visual Studio, such as opening files, etc. But that's going to be in part 2. So thanks for listening, and we'll see you on the next video.